The ministry of apologetics is often referred to as a discernment ministry. But that's something I think everybody in the church needs today. A little bit of apologetics, a little bit of discernment in their thinking. In fact, maybe more than just a little bit. How about a lot for the world that we live in today? It is also a misunderstood and often misconceived work to talk about apologetics and discernment, because oftentimes you're dealing with the work of other people or the thoughts of other people, and a lot of people are just uncomfortable with it. And they say that people like me, people who are in the ministry of apologetics, are just against everything. And that's not true. I'm for a lot of stuff. I'm for the Bible. I'm for Jesus as Lord and Savior. I'm for salvation by grace. I'm for the doctrines the church has stood on, and I hope you are too. But a lot of people misconstrued the idea of apologetics, just thinking that we're a bunch of guys who are against everything. And I've often said that I'm a real positive guy, that God has called to talk about some pretty negative stuff, but hopefully I can do it in such a way that it's just not, that you don't think that I'm against everything that comes along. The topic we're going to talk about here, that we're going to spin off from in this message, is one that I tried to get away from. I really didn't want to talk about it. I've been really busy this year. I didn't feel like that I wanted to spend the time to research another book that was out there. But this is just something I felt like I couldn't get away from. Is Jesus the only way to be reconciled to God? The Shack speaks about this. The Jesus of the Shack says to Mac, quote, "I am the best way any human can relate to Papa or Sarah Yu." The Shack's Jesus does not repeat the biblical emphatic claim that Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, the life." It says, "I am the best way." Now, what kind of gospel is that, if it's only an incomplete one? Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no man cometh unto the Father but by me." Jesus didn't say, "Me and Buddha are okay," or "Me and whoever you think is okay," or "Just your feelings will be enough." Jesus said faith in Him was the only way, by believing and trusting that He was the Messiah, and that His propitiation for our sins, His shedding of blood on the cross, is what it comes down to. Trusting in what He did for us, in who He is, God Almighty, God incarnate, walking in the flesh of a man, which the Father didn't do. And the Spirit didn't do, only Jesus. Papa speaks and says, "I don't need to punish people for sin. Sin is its own punishment, devouring you from the inside. It's not my purpose to punish sin. It's my joy to cure it." Page 120. Another glaring half-truth from a universalist point of view. The tragedy of the Shack's popularity isn't just that Paul Young has written a book that's so far off. The tragedy, again, is it's been avidly accepted by Christians, and that there's seemingly such a void for critical analysis and biblical thinking in the church today. This is why we called this DVD "The Death of Discernment: How the Shack Became the Number One Bestseller in Christianity." I am shocked about high-profile, once reliable Christians, and even one well-known apologetics ministry who is endorsing this book. I'm shocked by it. Again, where is the discernment in the church? The Apostle Paul speaks directly to us about this. Galatians chapter 1, verses 8 and 9. "But though we or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel unto you than that which we have preached unto you, let him be accursed. As we said before, so say I now again, if any man preach any other gospel unto you than that which ye received, let him be accursed." The Shack presents a view of God, but not the God. A Jesus, but not the Jesus. A Spirit, but not the Spirit. And the book contains a gospel and a Trinity, but it is not the gospel from the Bible, and it's not the Holy Trinity. Now, as I conclude, I just want to read for some notes that I wrote as I listened to Paul Young speak in October 2008 there at Warner Pacific in Portland. I wrote this: I like Paul Young. There are probably many nice people who teach and believe heretical doctrines and ideas, and he's one of them. reminds me of the way I felt when I listened to and encountered Brian McLaren, who is an emergent leader. Paul is genuinely a nice guy, and there's no doubt that many people have found some sort of help from the story as portrayed in the shack. Still, regardless of my own feelings, my allegiance isn't to my feelings about Young or even to the results that may come from the book. It is to the Bible. This is why I cannot in good conscience recommend the shack. Now here's some more of what I wrote in my notes that day. Listening to Young, I caught myself thinking of people who need to be healed of past hurts and delivered and become as transparent as Young wants everyone to believe that he is. It is not hard to imagine why so many people have bought cases of the book to give out. There are so many hurting people. And you know, just as soon as I wrote that down, there sitting in that auditorium, in the midst of that thought, I wrote, "Oh, how seductive. I just remembered the aberrant and unorthodox theology of the shack. I caught myself agreeing with the results of the shack and how emotionally many people may be helped by it. But then that's the exact problem of the shack, isn't it? That's how it's infiltrated so many Christian homes and lives. That's the seduction that's taken place. That's the lack of discernment that we're talking about here. Many are allowing their emotions to overrule God's authority and final truth as found in the Bible. I understand that people who have gone through extremely hard events like the sudden death or even murder of a loved one may have made a connection to this book, and the millions who have been abused as a child may have related to this even more. People who are grieving in a prolonged state of grief, anxiety, and pain have a tendency to overlook the things that disturb me about this book." You see, when he's written the book as Mac and as Missy, the father and daughter who is killed in the book, he's written them about himself. Both those characters encapsulate who Paul Young is and his pain. Still, I have, as a matter of how this book has touched hearts, it doesn't matter how that's happened. The flawed and even cultic theology and philosophy remains in the book. I believe that Satan is using this book to pervert the view of God to some and distort and even replace the Trinity in the minds of others and confuse some who are in a grieving state, and it may be more subtle to them. But about the erroneous views that he presents of God and salvation, make no mistake, it is deadly. The fact is, if a religious group taught the doctrines and beliefs found in the theology of this fictional book, it would be the relentless focus of every apologist and minister worth his or her salt who would go to great lengths to expose this as heresy. If there was a group out there who was following a goddess named Papa and worshiping it, people would be coming unglued, exposing it.